Jackson, where'd your running backs go? Hello everyone, welcome to the running back rankings for these videos we're going to be doing for the rankings. I actually recorded this video already with good buddy Tack. Unfortunately, the video got corrupted, so I'm going to have to redo this now. Thankfully, I got Tack to be so agreeable to rejoin and do it all again. I trust you guys will think this will be a good one, just like the first one was, obviously. Tack, would you like to introduce yourself? Yeah, what's up, you cornflake and having pussies? Let's get into this shit. All right, well, at number 12, that's a little egregious, Tack, by the way. Should be more polite next time. Man, fuck you. Anyway, at 12th, I had scrambled and wiggle-waggled. Evan, I don't really know what you were planning on going for here. You know, your running backs are awful. Now, Brian Robinson, it's not his fault. He's doing pretty fucking good. He had a mediocre week 3 against Buffalo, but that was just because Washington was getting shit on. That happens all the time. Don't worry about it. Overall, Brian Robinson's been pretty damn good for you. He's been a diamond in the rough for you this season. But on the off side of things, Antonio Gibson has been a shit stain in the toilet paper. Things really haven't been looking very good for him at all. Having both the running backs, I'd maybe try to trade Gibson, maybe try to get something else, maybe a bag of chips, something. But overall, he's horrible. So overall, then, you also have Ezekiel Elliott, who they've been saying they're trying to get more involved as the weeks go on. I will believe it when I see it. So far, they really haven't shown any signs of using him more. The first few weeks have been mediocre at best, but at least you might have a startable option in the upcoming weeks, maybe. But overall, things aren't looking too good. Pussy, what did you have here?
Well, you see, Justin, I had the same goddamn thing and whatnot. You see, the thing about Ezekiel Elliott is he ain't know how to fuck my sister quite like I know how to. And then you'll see over here around the 45 that Philadelphia's defense, yeah, they kind of did pretty good. But overall, Ezekiel Elliott's still ass, if you ask me. I'd trade him for a bag of tater chips. Okay, what about Robinson and Antonio Gibson? They're on the same goddamn team. I don't know what the hell Evan's doing, but it's Evan. Fuck you, Evan. Yeah, I agree. Fuck you, Evan. Piece of shit. Fuck you, piece of shit. Piece of shit. I hate you, piece of fuck. Alright, well, let's stop bullying Evan here, pussy, okay?
Let's get right into the number 11 spot, because it's pretty fair to say we both hate Evan.
Goddamn right.
Alright. Alright. That's a little excessive. Number 11. We have MILF. Well, at least I have MILF. We'll ask pussy who he has in a minute. MILF was previously ranked in the other video at 10th. He's now at 11th, so I think he dropped a little bit. Ramondre Stevenson has been disappointing. He's the other side of Ezekiel Elliott, where they're both getting touches, but neither are doing good. And yeah, it's very hard to rank him much higher than this. He does have the upside. It's arguable, but things aren't looking good over these past few weeks. The first 2 weeks he did solid, though. Jerick McChicken is not doing shit. He only did good week 3 because he was playing the fucking Bears, and they were kicking the Bears' ass by like 40 at halftime. So they put in their backups and said, go do the same shit, which he proceeded to do. And then you have Dalvin Cook, who honestly has been horrible this season. His only upside, at least to me, is if Breece Hall were to go down, maybe he can do good. But I was a huge Dalvin Cook fan before this, but yeah, he can't get yards per carry. He's not getting many looks. He's just not doing much. He's getting at least touches on the ball, but that's where his upside ends. Things just aren't looking good for Dalvin Cook. Maybe he starts playing against some easier defenses and starts doing more, but I kind of have my doubts, unless Breece Hall gets hurt. And Jamal Williams, I actually will give you some credit here, Milf. I think Jamal Williams will get better now that Kamara's back. As everybody knows with Williams, he's not known for being a yards guy, being a catching guy. He's known for going in there and stealing touchdowns, so if the Saints can start getting into the red zone and actually start moving this ball with the help of Kamara, I think it'll actually help Williams more than it'll hurt him, because he really didn't do anything in the first few weeks. So maybe going in there and getting Kamara actually helps. I mean, you're already at the floor. He can only go up, right? I hope. Anyway, but yeah, MILF was my number 11. Pussy, who did you actually have at your 11? Man, I had Mr. Steeler Girl, partially because I fucking hate the Steelers. Them motherfuckers, especially Ben Roethlisberger being a rapist and whatnot. Whoa. We don't accuse people of rape here, okay? Man, fuck that guy. Okay. Anyway, with Mr. Steeler Girl, why did you have them at your 11 spot here? Now, you see, the thing is, Jahmyr Gibbs is over here getting cucked like B-Dog does in the last November winter and whatnot, because Jahmyr Gibbs, you see, he's out here getting cooked up by the Lions, because the David Montgomery's going out there getting all the carries, whatnot, hooting and hollering, you know, to Baskin and Waskin, you name it. Jahmyr Gibbs just ain't getting these targets, he ain't getting the runs, he ain't doing much at all. Well, I will say, I actually agree, that's a pretty good point. He hasn't been looking great either. I just had Mr. Steeler Girl ranked a little bit higher, because he does still have that upside. But what about Miles Sanders? What did you think about Miles Sanders? He's been doing okay. I thought he was going to be the next Christian McCaffrey. Man, fuck that guy. Partially because he's black and whatnot. We don't like his sort of kind around here. And other than that, he's also not been able to do nothing in terms of this ball. He's doing horrible. Really, is that right? You think he's doing that bad? At least he's getting catches, right? Yeah, I guess so. But that still ain't nothing to warrant him over the 11 spot, I reckon. Okay, that's arguable. But what about... that's about it in terms of his running backs. He has Cam Akers. What about him? Well, you see, man, he has to deal with Alex Mattison. I think Alex Madison's actually been doing better than people are giving him credit for. I completely agree, Pussy. That's a pretty good point. We'll talk about him later with Karen's husband, but either way, Cam Akers definitely does have the upside. So I do think he could at least be startable throughout the weeks, wouldn't you think? Man, hell no. Look at hair like that. It looks like some fucking spaghetti noodles. Okay, you gotta chill tonight, Tack. You're a little bit crazy. But anyway, then he has Kareem Hunt, who, man, fuck Kareem Hunt. He's projecting negative 0.21 points and whatnot. My cousin could do better. Well, I mean, I'm not denying that, but it's a bye week. How is he projected negative points? Man, fuck this goofy ass app. I'm switching to ESPN. Oh, okay, that's a little egregious. You're still gonna finish the video, right? Nah, fuck you. Okay. Anyway. That's pretty much how I saw it with Mr. Steeler Girl. That's pretty much how it went down. And Mr. Steeler Girl was actually at my 10 spot. Who did you have at your 10 spot here, Pussy? Man, I had Toxic. I hate Toxic because he gets no bitches. But he has a girlfriend. Nobody gives a fuck about what he has, okay? Okay, that's fine. But why do you pick Toxic to be number 10 here? Now... You see, the thing is, I personally think, and this is me talking here, I think he's a little bit higher than how you have him ranked here. Well, I'll talk about him whenever we get to my side of things, but why is it that you have Toxic ranked so low, though? Man, James Cook is getting overlooked by everybody on this offense, whether it's Stephon Diggs, Gabe Davis, Joshua Allen himself. Man's Timothy. He could do anything, but... Overall, he ain't going to be doing too much, I reckon not. And then Alvin Kamara. Honestly, this whole offense is bad, other than the fact that Derek's last name is Carr. That's the sexiest name I've ever heard. Yeah, that's very true. That is a sexy last name. But, anyway, I'm back. Sorry about that, guys. I got a little busy doing something. But anyway, Tack, you were going on about A.J. Dillon. I didn't mean to cut you off there. Or about the... Toxic Empire running backs. What did you think about A.J. Dillon? Surely he's able to make up for something. Man, fuck that guy. The only thing good about him and nice and attractive about him, that gap between his teeth, it's looking pretty hot over there. I mean, if you're into that type of thing, Tack. But what about Zach Charbonnet? Maybe he has some upside with Kenneth Walker. Yeah, I guess so. I can't really fully deny that one. Alright. Well, I'll have you know he has fucking McLaughlin over here, Jaleel. That's a pretty good name, is it? Man, fuck Jaleel. That's some straight-ass ghetto bullshit. This is probably one of them liberal lies you're always talking about. I hate this shit going on. You know, I used to be a Bears fan. I used to have to look at all them reverse crackers in the hood and whatnot. It was horrible. Oh, okay, we're going racist mode now, Tack. I see how it is. All right. Either way, I can understand your point on Toxic. I had him a little bit higher. But you know what? This is where I had Mr. Steeler Girl, though. But, you know what, there is an argument for it. I think we're still somewhat close. I have a feeling you're going to put Toxic a little bit further up the list. Or not Toxic. I'm going to have Toxic a little bit further up the list, but not too much further.
What did you have for your number 9? I actually had Karen's husband. And I had MILF. As much as I love sexy MILFs, he just ain't it. Yeah, I agree there. We already talked about their running backs. I'm not a fan. Now, why'd you go and have Karen's husband in at number 9 spot? Well, I like Tony Pollard. Don't get me wrong, I think he's solid, but he is going to be having to worry about Deuce Vaughn and Rico Dowdle coming in and taking a lot of his snaps. Alex Mattison has been doing a lot better. We talked about that earlier, where he's been doing a lot better than people are giving him credit for, though. Not Zach Ertz, Alex Mattison. He's still getting most of the snaps, as you saw with that article. He's getting 17 carries, pretty good. He's doing solid in terms of the run game. He's getting receptions. He's pretty much doing everything to at least get solid points. He had a bad week, too, where he fumbled a lot. But he's not doing bad in the long terms of things. But either way, I don't think these running backs are really good enough to carry him higher on this list, though. He has three guys that are kind of what-if scenarios, where Samaje Perine could be solid if Javonte Williams were to go down, or Sean Johnson. I think the Bears plan on using him long-term, but for now, he's not fantasy-trustable. They're currently using Khalil Herbert a lot more. So if Khalil Herbert got hurt or something, he could be really good. And Chuba Hubbard could be really good if Miles Sanders were to go down or something like that. But for now, I don't trust any of these three. They're all kind of fantasy irrelevant, to be honest. So overall, yeah, I really don't trust this. Overall, what would you say about Karen's husband's running back? I notice you have them higher on your list. I'm guessing they're probably pretty close.
Man, no, they ain't no fucking close. They're pretty high up. They're probably higher than you, your sorry ass. Do you really have to be such a dick about everything? Man, fuck you, pussy. Okay, I see how it is. Anyway, yeah, Karen, why did you think Karen's husband was so much higher, though?
Well, Tony Pollard, I don't think he has to worry about none of them two running backs. Those other two running backs are like flies on a swatter. Maybe they're not as fit as a fiddle as Tony Pollard might be. Tony Pollard's been looking pretty damn good throughout this season. I'm not going to lie. And Alex Mattison's been looking pretty good outside of them fumbling issues. He just needs to stop having Sketty and Butter on a nightly basis, and maybe his hands will be a bit better. Okay, yeah. I gotta say, you gained quite the accent there, Tack.
Man, you make fun of my fucking accent all you want. At least I ain't B-Dog's sorry ass.
Yeah, that's pretty true. And then what do you think about those other three guys on the bench?
Man, they ain't worth a damn. They ain't why they're ranked high. They ain't why he's ranked low. They're all terrible.
Oh, okay. I agree completely. Next up, what did you have at your number 8 spot? I had Toxic Zenpai here. We already kind of talked about him. But I had him a little bit higher than you.
Man, I had a dictatorship. I'm still pissed off he wouldn't make all them trades with me and whatnot.
Okay, so you had dictatorship. Why overall did you not like him?
Nobody knows what the hell Jonathan Taylor's doing. He's just over here trying to collect the money bag and all that. I'm just tired of watching all the drama go down and him causing big dilemmas. He's like a goddamn NFL Kardashian at this point. You know about the Kardashians? Man, don't question what the hell I watch in my free time. This is a free country. This is America. Okay, I'm not questioning what you're doing. I'm just saying, you know about the Kardashians. And you had Kenneth Walker, who's pretty good. He's been doing solid all season. He's like Marshawn Lynch. Doing pretty solid around the board. I can't deny that, Tack. That's a pretty good point. I love Kenneth Walker. I actually have him higher, though. What do you think of Rashad White and Joshua Kelly?
And Joshua Kelly is dog shit. He ain't really worth much in terms of these fantasy points or anything. He ain't going to be doing nothing all year. And Rashad White, while I like his last name, I don't like the color of his skin. I wish he actually took his own advice with that name. Oh, wow, Tack, that is just way too far, don't you think? Nah, we did worse back in the 80s. Whoa, okay, buddy. I might have to start banning you from doing these videos, I'm not gonna lie. But overall, my opinion on everything is pretty close to what he said. Nobody knows what's going on with Jonathan Taylor. I do have dictatorship ranked quite a bit higher here, but overall, I do just have a big bias with Jonathan Taylor. I think he's going to be one of the best running backs in the league for whichever team he plays for, but there is a big question mark on it. Kenneth Walker, I do think he's like the next Marshawn Lynch. He's doing very fucking good so far this season. Not much downside. He's doing everything. He'll find a way to go in there and get points. Rashad White,
has been a little bit on the inconsistent side, but you can make an argument that he has played very good run defenses, so I think he might actually be better than people are crediting him for right now. And on top of that, he is going to have an easier schedule finishing out the year for the most part. There's still some tough games on there, though, don't get me wrong. But I had him higher. We'll talk about him in brief later on. But overall, I think Josh Kelly's going to improve, kind of like Jamal Williams, upon the return of Austin Ekeler, though. Because I think he's going to be another one that actually starts developing a rush game whenever Ekeler returns. But I guess only time can tell. Who did you have at your 7 spot here, pussy? I had Big Yawners. Man, I had Big Yawners, too. Me and you were starting to become alike. We're like stepbrothers. Whoa, whoa, whoa. We're not that close yet. Okay, you got to back it on up a few states. Anyway, Big Yawners as Aaron Jones, Jerome Ford, Zach Moss, and Gus Edwards and Justice Hill. I think I'm a really big fan of Aaron Jones. He's one of my most taken players in all of fantasy this season. I have in 5 leagues, as you'll see there. I took him not because he's like an amazing running back. He's a good running back, don't get me wrong. I took him because I thought Jordan Love would be ass this season. He has not been ass this season. He's actually been one of the better quarterbacks who's actually slinging the ball around even without Christian Watson. So he's definitely taking Aaron Jones. I mean, is definitely taking a step back here. I don't think he's as good as I expected him to be at the start of the season. You have Zach Moss. Either you or Rictatorship are going to be very good and probably boost up these rankings a little bit based on which one of you ends up getting the good end of the coin. If Taylor stays in Indianapolis, Moss becomes horrible. If Taylor gets traded, it's looking like Big Yawners has a huge W with a probably a running back one for the rest of the year that I could see outscoring Aaron Jones on a week-to-week basis. And that would be huge for Big Yawners. He would skyrocket up this list so fast. Jerome Ford's out there. He's done pretty solid in terms of fantasy. The Browns have shown time and time again with history where whether you're looking at Kareem Hunt, whether you're looking at D'Ernest Johnson for he was a running back 3 they used to have. The Browns will make whatever running back they're using just go in there and fucking work. Now, whether it's the yards he's getting or the touchdowns or the receptions, whatever he's doing, he will find a way to get points, even if it's not the typical fantasy way. And overall, that's pretty much all there is to talk about with Jerome Ford. He's probably a running back 1. Darth did a very good job at recovering with his fall apart at his original running back position. He went and picked up a lot of very good studs in free agency. And then you also have Gus Edwards and Justice Hill. If I were Darth, I would try to trade one of these guys away and keep the other one. Just because you're never going to be in a situation where you need both of them or that one of them is going to be that much better than the other. But you can probably get some value for it. I wouldn't recommend keeping both on your free agency list, though, or on your bench, though. Yeah, I would probably try to trade one away and maybe get something better. What did you think, pussy? Yeah, I pretty much agreed with everything you said. I definitely don't understand why these motherfuckers keep taking 2 quarterbacks per team. I think it's pretty stupid myself. You know, me personally, whenever I'm having an orgy, I prefer 2 pieces of Oreo and only 1 piece of cream. It looks like Darth is going for the triple chocolate bouquet here. You really gotta calm down here, Tech. Hey, facts are just facts. I'm just here. I just work here, okay? Didn't you used to work at a... Don't you dare tell them where I work and whatnot. This is a nationwide... Well, what the fuck are you talking about, bro? Anyway, let's move on to our number 6 spot. I had J-Bay. Now, J-Bay has Austin Ekeler, Damian Pierce, Breece Hall, David Montgomery, Jeff Wilson, and he had Kenneth Gainwell. Now, Austin Ekeler could come back and be one of the best running backs in the league. His only issue is if he can actually stay healthy, which isn't looking good so far. He's had a pretty good injury list throughout his NFL career. They're starting to come back again this year, though, but maybe he comes back and is able to stay healthy. He could be one of the best running backs in the league. His only question mark is if he can stay healthy. Damian Pierce and Breece Hall are in an interesting position where Breece Hall would be better if the Jets could start getting a passing game, and Damian Pierce would be better if the Texans were to start using their running game more, because they're both in very unbalanced offenses, and usually unbalanced offenses don't work too well in terms of fantasy just because defenses start scheming around it. Breece Hall is pretty much relying on big plays to make his games. if he can't get those big plays with the plays he does get, his weeks are kind of useless. But lucky for him, weeks 1 and 4, he was able to have big breakoff plays that kind of salvaged his week. While Damian Pierce really doesn't get many attempts at the ball, and well, he does, but they're mostly going to be passing here, and a lot of the times they just get stuffed at the run game. Maybe once the O-line gets better, he can go in there and start doing better himself. But I didn't think I could rank J-Babe too much higher here. I think both Kenneth Gainwell and Jeff Wilson are pretty much irrelevant from a fantasy point of view at this point. David Montgomery's going in there, and yeah, I think he fucked Dan Campbell's wife or something like that, because I think Jahmyr Gibbs did. David Montgomery's out there getting targets left and right, carries left and right, mostly carries, not really targets, but he is getting a few. Now, David Montgomery is the first running back or player that I've ever seen come back from an injury where there was a rookie who hasn't been injured yet and outscored that rookie with 3-1 snaps, even while being injury prone and returning from an injury on a Thursday night football game. Yeah, if you're a Jahmyr Gibbs fan or owner, that is looking pretty concerning. So, Mr. Steeler Girl, thus why the intro. Your running backs are kind of dog shit now, but for J-Bay, David Montgomery, looking very fucking good. He's getting a shit ton of carries. He's getting touchdowns. He's getting a few catches here and there, but that's just kind of bonus. But overall, if you're J-Bay, this is a very good sign for you. Yeah, just things aren't looking good for Jahmyr Gibbs, though. Pussy, did you have anything you wanted to add here to all this? Man, I just wanted to say I'm a huge fan of that Austin Eckler or whatnot. Thank you for giving us the shout-out for the tournament. Thing was awesome. Anyway, I fucking hate certain types of people in this group here. But either way, David Montgomery is looking pretty goddamn good. Breece Hall is looking pretty goddamn bad. Kenneth Gainwell, Jeff Wilson, may as well cut. Maybe trade him for me. I'll give him a fucking Tootsie Roll or something. Okay, that's fair. Next up is the number 6. First, who did you have at your number 6 here, pussy? I had Karen's husband. Okay, so you had Karen just a bit higher than I had him. I think I kind of overvalued Toxic and Mr. Steeler Girl. You kind of overvalued Karen's husband and J-Bay here a little bit compared to mine. But overall, that's about it. We'll go on to the number 5 spot. Here's where I actually had Rictatorship. Who did you have here? This is where I had J-Bay. Okay, so we don't really have to talk about these guys much. We already went over them for the most part. Who did you have at your number 4? Man, I had PMC Wagner. Now, see, the thing is, I don't understand what it is with all these motherfuckers having this many jigaboos on the same team. Dude, you can't be saying, I don't give a fuck what I'm saying. I'm saying whatever the hell I want. Oh, that's great, but you cannot be doing this shit, Tack. This is a Christian YouTube channel, I'll have you know. We don't accept any kind of racism. Anyway, whatnot is going on. He has Devon a chain. He got Raheem Mustard and whatnot. Mr. Mustard, some call him. But overall, I think these guys are doing solid for what it's worth. But I don't think they're going to keep this shit up and whatnot. They got Isaiah Pacheco. He's going in there. I just can't rank him any higher than some of these guys. It's a pretty good running room. But I just can't see it overall going much better than some of these other guys that are ranked higher. Especially my good Lord running back myself that the Lord blessed me with at this time. Okay, that's respectable. But number 4 for me. Actually, I'll talk about these guys first. I definitely agree. I don't think a chain or Mostert are going to be able to keep it up. Too many weapons on that offense. It's a pass-heavy offense. I think maybe one of the two of them might be able to keep it up on a week-to-week basis, but I think PMC is going to be kind of guessing at which one it's going to be. And I don't think that it's going to be like a 60-point week. It might be like a 20-point week on a week-to-week basis if he's lucky. And Mixon has been pretty consistent. He's been solid for the Bengals so far this season, even behind the shitty offense. If the offense can get rolling, then maybe he can start doing better. And now, PMC actually has something interesting here, where he has the stack of Mahomes and Pacheco. Usually quarterback running back stacks don't work in fantasy, but since Mahomes has no target other than Travis Kelce, this stack is actually looking pretty good, where Pacheco can just keep taking all these fucking dump-off passes from Mahomes. So far, if he starts getting used more with these catches, you see week 1, 4 for 31, week 2, 3 for 43, when you get this guy the ball, it usually works. So if the Chiefs start doing that more, which I'm anticipating they do, I could see this being a pretty good week for him. Anyway, other than that, I don't really think there's really too much that Pussy didn't really talk about here. Next up at number 4 for me, on my side of the list, I actually had Pussy. Man, you motherfucker, you didn't put me at number 1. What the fuck is wrong with you? I ought to come to whatever state you done lived in last year ago, and I ought to whoop your ass with a 12-gauge shotgun broom. The fuck is a shotgun broom? You want to find out, motherfucker? No, I don't really. I don't really give a fuck. But either way, I got Pussy. Pussy's at number 4 on my list. He has Josh Jacobs, James Conner, Travis Etienne, and Najee Harris. Besides Najee sounding like a political party in the 1940s that were very excited, exciting to watch, that decided to go and fucking have a football drive on the rest of Europe. Besides that, this running back room is solid around the board. I just don't quite think they have the upside of some of these other guys. Jacobs so far has been struggling because of the O-line, but now that Garoppolo's out, he's been doing pretty good. Maybe he can keep this up when Garoppolo returns. I personally don't think so, because Garoppolo likes taking shots even though he sucks at it. But either way, though, you do see Josh Jacobs struggling throughout the first weeks of the season. He's getting a lot of attempts at least, so that's solid. He does have the upside of last year. But I do think they need to stop airing the ball out as much to Davante Adams and Jacoby Myers for that to work. As for James Conner with the return of Kyler Murray, yeah, I'm definitely thinking that you're onto something there. I think with James Conner coming back, or with Kyler Murray coming back, the Cardinals could score a lot more touchdowns, which is what James Conner is known for. So overall, I don't think there's much to be concerned about that 49ers game, one of the toughest run defenses in the league. But when Kyler Murray comes back, this dude might actually be one of the best running backs to have in fantasy, at least in terms of consistency. I don't think he'll have any like 40-plus point games, but who knows? He's been pretty good in the past year, and that was with DeAndre Hopkins. Then you also have Etienne. Don't even get me started on Etienne. That fucking Trevor Lawrence, whatnot, with the goofy-ass haircut, always ignoring Etienne when he's wide the fuck open down the middle of the field. Shit's ridiculous. I mean, I agree. I kind of put a bet on him, lost some. Don't get me started. I fucking hate them Cincinnati Bengals. Lost me 50 dung bucks on goddamn bucks. Dangle on my fucking bet. Made me want to go kill myself. That's not very appropriate there, Pussy. What would you say here? Man, fuck that. Okay, yeah, you know what? You're right. But anyway, Etienne's been a little bit annoying this year just because he kind of gets overshadowed by the rest of the offense, but at least he's getting the attempts to go in there and do everything. You'd hope for a bit more consistency with the receiving, but the receiving has been good overall nonetheless. He's looked like a solid running back in terms of fantasy around the board. Like I said, I think all these guys that he has are solid with the exception of Najee Harris. I just don't think any of them have the insane upside as the top three guys. Najee Harris has been, he did outplay Jaylen Warren for whatever that's worth this last week, but I don't think he's going to be able to keep up this kind of week on a week-to-week basis. He does have a tough schedule until about the ending of the season. So overall, I don't really think Najee Harris is that great. I think it was a solid backup option, maybe a flexible option, but he's really not going to be that great for you, even if the stars align for him. I just think he'll be okay. Without further ado, let's get right on into the number 3 spot of things here. This is where I had PMC. Now, I think Pussy's team is going to be a lot more consistent with these running backs, but PMC does have that insane upside where Raheem Mostert, in weeks past, has put up 45, and Devon Achane did decide to go up and put fucking 30 and 62. They definitely have the upside. If I was PMC, I would try to trade one of these running backs away. The problem is he's kind of asking for way too much for these guys, I think, because I don't think these guys are going to be that consistent at doing this. I do think they'll always have the upside of it, though, at least, but it's going to be hard to justify trading as much as I think PMC is hoping for here. And overall, I did pretty much just agree with everything Pussy said. I just think that PMC just has the upside here. Just not as consistent in terms of everything overall as PMC's or as Pussy's going to be, in my opinion. Who did you actually have here, Pussy?
Oh, man, I actually done had Booty Basher. I like that guy's name. It's very creative. It makes me excited and whatnot. We got a good old white boy here in Christian McCaffrey. This is what we like to see. Southern raised. Isn't he from Stanford? Don't worry about it. Okay.
And anyway, they also got Derrick Henry and DeAndre Swift. Christian McCaffrey's best running back in the league, hands down. Ain't no question about nothing that and whatnot. Derrick Henry, he's looking like a beast, but I don't trust that O-line. They're looking horrible. The consistency factor just ain't there to me. DeAndre Swift, they always got the push-tush going on and whatnot with the Philadelphia Eagles running up the QB sneak to get touchdowns. DeAndre Swift is getting fucked over left and right on that. I don't know if I'm going to be able to see his season continuing to be as consistent as it's been, but overall he does keep proving me wrong time and time again, though. And Jalen Warren, I hate that cousin fucking some bitch. He keeps stealing all the touches from Najee Harris. And he probably likes to touch kids too or something. I just don't know. This dude just ain't. I hate this motherfucker. Yeah, that's fair, but I don't think you can use that as a reason to rank Booty lower, can you? I mean, he's on my side of the list. I can do whatever hell I want. That's fair, I guess. I had Booty ranked a bit higher. I'll talk about him in a bit. At my number two, I had myself. Who did you have, pussy? Yeah, I had you at number two, too. Okay, so that's good. We agree that I'm pretty much knocking on the door of number one, but I'm not exactly number one yet. Yeah, Bijan Robinson's been great this season. He had that mediocre week three. His big question will be about how good his schedule will be until the ending of the season, where it's a very tough schedule to play. That's where we'll find out how good he truly is. But for now, in terms of real life, he's arguably been the best running back in the league outside of week three. Week one, he's getting 5.6 yards per carry. Week two, he's getting about 6 yards per carry. Week three, he's doing another really good week, 14 for 105. Dude is doing fantastic in terms of real life, and that's not even counting his receiving, at least 4 catches per game. The dude is pretty much doing it all around the board. Yeah, Bijan is probably the ideal running back one you could have in fantasy. I don't think he'll have that upside of like Christian McCaffrey, for example, but he is very good. Kyren Williams, he's been a huge surprise to everyone. He's gone out there and got like 30 points per week, or 18 points week 1, 30 points week 2, 25 week 4, 8 points for week 3. But he's gone out there and surprised everyone. He's been getting touchdowns left and right. He's been getting some good catches outside of week 1. I'm just now realizing, how does this dude have 0 catches for 2 yards? I don't understand Yahoo, but you know what? We'll just kind of accept it. But anyway, he's been a huge diamond in the rough for me. I don't think he's going to go and do this on a week-to-week basis. Don't get me wrong in the slightest. But for what it's worth, he has done pretty good. And then I also have Saquon Barkley, who's probably an indisputable top 5 running back in terms of fantasy if he can stay healthy. The question is if he can stay healthy or not. I don't think he is going to be a consistent guy in terms of the health. Ignore my battery. Don't tell Gino, please. Gino will murder me if he finds out my battery is low. Anyway, Saquon's a very good option. One of the best you can have in fantasy. If he can stay healthy, of course. But I think it'll also help that whole Giants offense start getting moving. And they will have the return of their left tackle coming in. Now, Javonte Williams is somebody that I kind of took hoping that he comes back and starts getting healthier as the weeks go on and starts getting used more, and then he got hurt again. So I don't really give 2 flying fucks about this guy, to be honest. Now, he kind of is losing all credibility, plus he's starting to go up against some tougher matchups here in the middle part of the season. Yeah, he's going to be riding the bench for me. He's a solid backup to have, I think, but I'm not really too excited about him. So if anybody wants a running back in a trade, just hit me up, I guess. And then Khalil Herbert as well. I think they're going to be trying to use Roschon Johnson a bit more, but so far, things are leaning in the direction of Khalil Herbert. He had a pretty good week 4, but other than that, the season's been mid at best. And yeah, he's been kind of struggling to do much. But for a running back 5, I can't complain. He's done solid. But yeah, he's nothing really special. Just pretty much better than what's on free agency, to be honest. What did you think here about all my guys, pussy?
Man, Bijan Robinson, what the fuck kind of sorry-ass name is Bijan? His hair looks like a goddamn rooster. It wakes me up in last November's morning because whatnot, and the sky's always looking purple. But what's going on here is these government conspiracies are changing what's going on with Kyren Williams. Kyren Williams, time and time again, I say he ain't going to do nothing, and then here he comes with his twinkle toes looking ass. He comes in here, and he outproduces. He does all sorts of weird shit. He does all types of those pyrotechnics and aerodynamics and whatnot.
he's out there doing it all, but yeah, I don't think it's going to continue or whatnot. Saquon Barkley, I like the last name Bark. Yeah, I grew up chewing on bark with my teeth, and yeah, it was looking pretty good. I even wiped my ass with some tree bark back in the day. I got poison oak all over it. And overall, we got Saquon Barkley. He's doing pretty good throughout the season and whatnot. I just don't think I like him more than some of these other guys, especially the guys on my team. My guys are just Himothy. What the fuck is Himothy? Anyway, my guys are just Himothy. And Khalil Herbert and Javonte Williams are okay backup options, but I wouldn't be too excited about them, though. Yeah, that's fair. Who do you have at number one? Man, I got myself. Now, you see, the thing about my here team is I built myself not just a God squad. We got God killers. My guys all are the best guys that ever could exist. They're all cornbread fed. They all can go out there and they can hunt. They can fish. They can do anything. Last names like Connor and Jacobs. What else could you really ask for? Best offenses in the league. They're the best reception guys, best blocking guys. They're the best you've ever seen in the world and whatnot. They're absolutely the best around the board. There's just nobody better out there. Higher upside, higher everything, higher bitches, higher everything. They can do it all. Well, I disagree for sure, but I do think you have a very good running game. Okay. My number one is actually Booty Basher with Christian McCaffrey, Derrick Henry, and DeAndre Swift. Overall, Christian McCaffrey's been undisputedly the number one running back in all of fantasy. I think regardless of what happens with, say, Austin Eckler, say, Bijan Robinson or Saquon Barkley, I think no matter what happens, Christian McCaffrey's going to be number one in fantasy. He does have a tougher few games here, which I still think he'll do fucking phenomenal. I think this will be his worst matchup of the season against Dallas, but other than that, he's been very good. DeAndre Swift, I didn't really like him coming into the season because of all the running backs, but pretty much all the running backs are now gone. Like, Kenneth Gainwell is the only guy who's arguably there to take his snaps away. So I think he's going to be one of the best flex options you have in all of fantasy here. Derrick Henry, while he hasn't been as consistent as he's been in years past, is still able to go out there and get you a good 15 points per week, with the exception of week 3 against the Browns. I think that won't be too common, though. I think he'll do pretty good as the season goes on. Don't get me wrong, he's not going to be that Derrick Henry that was out there competing with Christian McCaffrey on a week-to-week basis by any means. But overall, he is very fucking good. I still think he'll be one of the best running back twos you can have in all of fantasy. At least they're planning on using him. This is an amazing running back core. Booty, you did a very good job putting this together. Other than that, I think that's about it. Pussy, do you have anything to add? Nah, not really. This ranking video is kind of shitty, I'm not going to lie. This was kind of all thrown together in about 10 minutes by a motherfucker with 4% battery on his phone and whatnot. How do you know how much battery my phone has? Man, shut the fuck up. Okay, I guess. But anyway, I'm going to go hang out. Where the hell's B-Dog at? I'm going to go try to have a three-way with him and my sister or my step-cousin or something like that. B-Dog, you want in on this? Yeah, Trevor, I want in on this. Come give me them hot old kitties and titties. What the fuck is going on here? Anyway, I'll catch you guys later. I'll talk to you about matchup of the week tonight. God damn it. Fucking Tack and B-Dog are going fucking nuts, dude. Hey, fuck you. Okay, see you guys.